In 2022, Tory Bruno, the CEO of United Launch Alliance, or ULA, along with other experts, proposed an interesting idea, a US Strategic Propellant Reserve. The proposal, if implemented, would support the US Space Force and the Department of Defense, as well as helping US commercial space startups. For those unfamiliar, ULA is a key player in the aerospace industry, known for launching the Delta IV and Atlas V rockets, and now introducing its advanced Vulcan Centaur launch vehicle. This video looks at the proposal, focusing on its potential to help small space startups. The Strategic Propellant Reserve proposal involves storing propellant derived from lunar water ice at a number of key locations in cislunar space. The reserve would maintain a 2-year supply of propellant to ensure resilience for critical missions. Managed through a public-private partnership, operations could start as early as 2028, providing a robust infrastructure for space exploration. The benefits for small space startups are plenty. For instance, a reliable propellant supply chain creates opportunities for startups to offer on-orbit construction, lunar mining, space logistics, all of which will drive the cislunar economy. A 3 trillion cislunar economy in the next 30 years. The study proposes a strategic propellant reserve using lunar-derived propellant could grow the cislunar economy by over $3 trillion over the next 30 years. It gives the US the ability to maneuver freely within space and remove constraints on launch windows and vehicle availability. In addition, large crewed missions require propellant in space. Going to the moon under the Artemis program requires anywhere between 4 and 12 tanker refillings in low Earth orbit for the Starship vehicle. Where to station propellant reserves? The study suggests stationing propellant reserves in low Earth orbit, the lunar surface, and later on in Mars orbit. The idea is to ensure there is a critical amount of propellant in cislunar space at all times. The proposed reserves would serve key stakeholders, including NASA for crewed lunar missions, the US Space Force, the US Department of Defense, and commercial space startups. By maintaining propellant depots in LEO, on the Moon, and around Mars, the strategy ensures missions are resilient, with plenty of operational flexibility, maintaining high margins of safety, which NASA likes to have. The study estimates an investment of $15 billion to $26 billion over 30 years. That's less than $1 billion annually. This modest commitment could greatly boost commercial space development and operations, far surpassing the initial costs. Stationing propellant in orbit can be highly effective for boosting space operations, because rockets launched from Earth are usually 95% propellant by mass. By the time the vehicle has escaped most of the gravity from Earth to reach orbit, it's almost empty of fuel. Most satellites can only perform minimal tasks, such as station keeping or small delta V maneuvers to avoid debris. By providing pre-positioned propellant, orbital depots enable spacecraft to refuel, extending their range and capabilities for lunar missions, satellite servicing, or deep space exploration. The Moon offers more than just propellant resources like water, hydrogen, and oxygen. Prospecting could unlock industrial metals for constructing lunar settlements, power systems, communication infrastructure, and scientific equipment. Abundant lunar materials such as silica and aluminium could be processed to build solar panels on the Moon or in cislunar space, supporting the development of solar power stations to meet growing energy demands. The study provides a graphic of the expected timeline and cost when using strategic propellant reserves to boost cislunar activities. I won't go into the funding requirements, but for those interested, it's covered in detail in the study, which is linked to in the video description. Commercial demand. An LEO propellant station enables reusable space tugs to perform complex orbital maneuvers. These tugs could reposition satellites, such as transferring them from LEO to geostationary orbit, or adjusting orbital inclinations, maneuvers that are typically costly and fuel-intensive. The US Space Force has emphasized the importance of maneuvering without regret, the ability to execute dynamic orbital changes without depleting fuel reserves. An LEO propellant depot directly supports this goal, enabling the Space Force to maintain agile and responsive operations in space. For NASA's Artemis program, an LEO propellant station simplifies logistics by ensuring a constant fuel supply for lunar missions. This reduces the time and complexity of transporting crew and cargo to the moon. A spacecraft can refuel in orbit before departure. The Propellant Reserve supports ambitious lunar exploration goals. The propellant station creates a dynamic marketplace. Various companies can compete to refill the propellant station's reserves, driving down costs. Meanwhile, commercial entities can purchase propellant at market prices. Startups focusing on asteroid mining and lunar ice extraction stand to gain the most. An LEO station provides a ready market for their products, such as water-derived hydrogen and oxygen propellants. This demand encourages investment and growth in resource extraction, paving the way for a sustainable space economy. Proposed changes to the propellant storage reserve. The proposed US Strategic Propellant Reserve, initially designed to include stations in near rectilinear halo orbit, or NRHO for short, low Earth orbit, the lunar surface, and Mars orbit, requires adjustment if NASA cancels the Gateway, Orion, and the Space Launch System after Artemis 3. This shift in strategy provides an opportunity to optimize the reserve's configuration for greater efficiency and support for lunar operations. With the potential cancellation of key elements of the NASA Artemis program, NRHO, originally chosen to support these systems, becomes less relevant. Instead, a propellant station in low lunar orbit, or LLO for short, approximately 100 kilometers above the lunar surface, offers more advantages for crewed and uncrewed lunar missions. Transitioning to LLO aligns with the revised concept of operations that prioritizes simplicity and efficiency. Moving from the lunar surface to LLO requires approximately 1.87 kilometers per second of delta V, compared to 2.5 kilometers per second for NRHO. This reduction of over 600 meters per second lowers energy costs, making lunar operations more efficient. A low lunar orbit station enables reusable lunar vehicles, such as SpaceX's Lunar Starship. While the Lunar Starship lacks a heat shield for Earth return, it can operate continuously in cislunar space, landing and taking off from multiple lunar sites. Billions of tons of lunar water ice are estimated to exist on the moon, which can be processed into hydrogen and oxygen propellants. When combined with water-rich asteroids in near-Earth space, the potential for propellant production is enormous. A low lunar orbit station, paired with lunar surface reserve near water ice deposits, creates a robust supply chain, helping to sustain cislunar operations. Propellant locations and rationale. Three locations are proposed for propellant storage reserves. Low Earth orbit, or LEO. Positioning propellant stations in low Earth orbit at altitudes of 200 to 2,000 kilometers is essential to support a wide range of satellites, commercial space stations, and military operations concentrated in this region. By setting up multiple stations, the US can ensure resilience, avoiding single points of failure, and driving competition in the space economy. These stations enable satellite servicing, extending operational lifespans through refueling and maintenance. They also facilitate orbital debris removal and end-of-life decommissioning, contributing to a cleaner and safer orbital environment. Propellant stations in LEO help grow the commercial space sector. They provide fuel for commercial space stations, private astronaut missions, and space tourism, enabling cost-effective and frequent operations. By reducing the need for satellites and spacecraft to carry large fuel reserves, these propellant stations lower launch costs and provide operational flexibility. LEO propellant stations serve as launch pads for missions beyond Earth. Space docks or spacecraft can refuel in LEO, gaining the extra delta V needed to reach distant destinations without relying on time-consuming gravity assists. This capability is particularly valuable for scientific missions to the outer solar system, where direct trajectories can greatly reduce travel times. The US is exploring concepts like the Golden Dome, a proposed air defense system comprising hundreds or thousands of LEO satellites. Propellant stations would play a vital role in maintaining these satellites, providing the fuel needed for station keeping, maneuvering, and rapid response to threats, ensuring continuous and robust defense coverage. Low Lunar Orbit, or LLO for short. Locating propellant depot in low lunar orbit, approximately 100 kilometers above the lunar surface, streamlines the concept of operations for both crewed and cargo missions to the moon. This placement supports lunar operations by offering simplicity, accessibility, and efficiency. Not all missions need to land on the moon. For instance, lunar data relay communication satellites and prospecting satellites would stay in low lunar orbit. A propellant station here can supply these satellites, as well as lunar landers arriving or departing from the moon, ensuring they remain operational and efficient. With an orbital period of just 2 hours, LLO provides frequent launch windows to and from the lunar surface. This rapid cycle contrasts sharply with the 6 to 7 day period of a near-rectilinear halo orbit, simplifying mission planning. Moreover, traveling from the lunar surface to LLO requires a delta V of only 1.87 kilometers per second compared to 2.5 kilometers per second for NRHO. This lower energy simplifies logistics, making it easier to transport propellant to and from the moon. In a medical emergency requiring a swift return to Earth, a low lunar orbit propellant depot offers an advantage. Launch windows to the station open up every 2 hours, ensuring rapid access. In contrast, an NRHO station, in the worst case scenario, could be 6 to 7 days away due to its elliptical orbit. For crew safety, low lunar orbit's proximity and accessibility are unmatched. While low lunar orbit excels in supporting lunar-centric operations, it is less well-suited for missions beyond the moon. NRHO's higher energy orbit and greater distance from the moon make it more versatile for deep space objectives. Additionally, low lunar orbit requires more frequent station-keeping maneuvers due to lunar mask-ons, gravitational anomalies that perturb orbits and consume propellant. However, selecting frozen orbits that mostly avoid these anomalies can mitigate this issue, maintaining stability with minimal effort. Despite its drawbacks, low lunar orbit stands out as a superior location for a propellant depot. Its frequent launch windows, lower delta V requirements, and ability to support both surface missions and orbital assets make it ideal for lunar operations. By addressing station keeping challenges through careful orbit selection, low lunar orbit offers a practical, efficient, and safe solution for advancing lunar exploration and development. Lunar surface. Lunar landers would benefit from a propellant reserve on the surface, ideally near lunar water ice deposits. This would support reuse of lunar landers, potentially allowing them to take off and land at different locations on the moon. Beyond propulsion, a propellant station on the lunar surface provides critical resources for lunar bases. Water ice can be processed into water, hydrogen, and oxygen, which fuel cells can use to generate power. Additionally, these resources supply life support systems with drinking water and breathable oxygen, ensuring crew safety and comfort during extended missions. By enabling reusable landers and sustaining lunar bases, a surface propellant reserve boosts commercial lunar activities. It supports industries such as resource extraction, manufacturing, and tourism, creating a robust infrastructure for commercial space startups to thrive on the moon. A propellant reserve placed near water ice deposits is a cornerstone for advancing lunar exploration. Mars Propellant Reserve, ensuring mission success. With a potential Mars First strategy under Jared Isaacman as NASA's next administrator, setting up a propellant reserve in Mars orbit could improve mission reliability and safety. This station would support ambitious crewed missions and align with NASA's commitment to robust safety margins. Landing on Mars, taking off, and returning to Earth with a single tank of fuel is not possible, even for advanced vehicles like SpaceX's Starship. Instead, propellant, likely methane and oxygen, must be produced on the Martian surface using in-situ resource utilization. A Mars orbit propellant reserve serves as a critical backup if surface production falls short or issues arise like storage leaks. NASA prioritizes large safety margins, particularly for crewed missions. A propellant station in Mars orbit enables emergency return trips at any time, providing a vital safety net. This reserve ensures that crews can depart Mars promptly in a crisis. By mitigating risks associated with surface propellant production and enabling emergency crew returns, this station improves the chances of successful Mars missions and the safety of crewed Mars missions, paving the way for sustained human exploration of the Red Planet. Final thoughts. The creation of a US Strategic Propellant Reserve supports commercial and military stakeholders. With a steady supply of lunar-derived propellant, This initiative enables safe exploration beyond low Earth orbit, reducing the cost of in-space transportation and accelerating a wide range of commercial activities, from resource mining to space tourism. A public-private partnership arrangement where the private side takes on little risk and the public side provides capital expenditures in exchange for a boost in commercial Cislunar activities. With propellant reserves in place, US entities such as startups, the US Space Force and the Department of Defense would gain greater freedom to maneuver in space. In contrast, other nations and non-US companies would remain limited to basic station keeping and minor operations, as is currently the case. This strategic edge positions the US as a leader in global space activities. Do you support the idea of the US establishing strategic propellant reserves in space? If so, are the locations mentioned the best places for these depots, or would other locations be preferable? Let me know in the comments section below. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. A quick note, Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.